وأنت تحمل مسؤوليتها.
And let me say this in English so you can understand what I'm saying.
I have translation.
No, I know you have translation, but I just want to make sure you get it right. There will come a day that we will see far more radical, extremist, and terrorists coming out of Europe because of lack of decision-making, trying to be politically correct, or assuming that they know the Middle East and they know Islam and they know the others far better than we do. And I'm sorry, but that's pure ignorance.
Right. So welcome to the show. This is a reason show. So for now, the Arabs are pushing back. The Asians are pushing back. Now, it's only the African who's still haven't recognized what is going on around the world. Now, here's the reason. Hear me this. You see, there was a time that they told us that these people, these colonial masters, are the intelligent people. They are the knowledgeable people. They are the smartest people. And we believe that all because of slavery. Now, the results on the ground has proven to us that this is not true. And you and I know that it's not true. But the reason why we can't be bold to stand up against this imperialism and this the atrocities that these people have caused, especially the continent of Africa, is that the school that they put us through, the school system, has able to tame us down, and that we are not able to recognize the narrative that they set to destroy the whole of continent of Africa. Now, this is the reason, so we are here to reason. You know, when this is a man in Saudi Arabia, UAE, they are also pushing back against any propaganda that has been set for a long time. Now, the Arabs are being on their toe. They have waked up from their sleep. It's only the African who still is asleep and still believes that everything they told us is true. But as I said, the results on the ground has proven to us that it is not true that they are the most intelligent people, the knowledgeable, the skillful. It's not true. But it's all because of the deliberate attempt, the intentionally created or engineered systematic autocratic system which set up by all the institutions around the world. That is why you still believe that anything come from the United Nations or the United States or the European Union, it is true, it is legitimate. That's not the fact of the day, because when you check the results, most of times the disorders of these Europeans tend to be the order of the day. Take it or leave it on, and you can quote me. I'm saying that the disorders of Europeans or the America tends to be the order of the day, and I'll show you why. Here is the reason. Show now, you as a young African, you always keep continuously crying, saying we have all the resources, we have this, that, this and that. Gold, diamond, coffee, manganese, coal, cotton, rubber, every resource that fills the world is in the continent of Africa. But why? Now, these Europeans and these colonial masters set a standard for us that everybody should believe that Africa is poor. Now, you see the double standard. If it's true that this continent is poor, why then the world is food basket is in the continent of Africa? Have you ever asked yourself? What do you discuss? Here's the residual. CAA. Now, I am going to show you a video that is the cause of all your problems after slavery. And these people are not backing down. So I am targeting you, or I'm provoking you, young Africans, to start reasoning. Start to recognize what is going on. Not just a political gimmick. Not just a daily routine like we vote and then we start to complain about our leaders are no good leaders. No, the leaders are even worse than you. So don't ever put your trust on them. Now, watch here. These are the major atrocities still causing and continuously using this tactics as a tool to destabilize your future. Now, whenever you start to talk about your resources that your country have or had, Don't ever forget that somebody is in charge and somebody controls that in any form, whether politically, religiously, socially, somebody is in charge to control that. So anytime you recognize this, that's where you know where to fight back, where to push back before talking about politics or whatever. Because you know why? Somebody brought a politician and somebody become a politician. So whenever the people are awake, they will make sure we don't need a puppet, because the puppet always represents the slave master. And you know what I'm talking about. Now, listen to David, this video. This is a diplomat or, you know, a serviceman from America. And he's going to show you why you are not going to benefit from your gold or your diamond or any raw material that you know is from Africa. This is the reason. And they are not playing. It's not a joke. It's only a joke for those who are still asleep and the dumbest people in Africa, the so-called educated fools. Those are the people that these messages become useless to them. If you're an educated fool and you are a dumb person that you don't know what's going on and you think Chinese or America or Europeans is coming to build it for you because you have a certificate, that is where the IQ level is low. Watch this here.
Sub-Saharan Africa has been fundamental to the global prosperity of the advanced countries. Okay? And Africa had a role to play. It has a role as a raw material producer. We will not allow Sub-Saharan Africa to escape that. Okay, we do everything to keep Sub-Saharan Africa where it is, also impoverished. It's absolutely vital for the prosperity of everyone else. So let's get clear about that. Okay, and this means all the economic structures, all the global institutions, and the economics we teach everyone is all designed to keep Africa exactly where it is. And whether it is Europe or US or now China, it's always the same. We need Africa to be impoverished because we need those raw materials and we need them dirt cheap. Sub-Saharan okay. Africa.
Thank you. Thank you for the information. Yeah, they have made the plan. The orchestrated or the intentionally created system is already available. Now, I'm not sure the day that this guy was saying this, they thought it's going to come out for a young Africans to stand up and then expose this video. Now, I'm exposing this to you. But only thing is, they know they already have the process, the procedure, or the structures in place to counter whenever the young Africans start to push back. They know. But it doesn't take anything from us to also design a strategy. Now, listen, I'm speaking English for them to understand. Because you know why? This is the language that you understand. You see, when I played the first video, you see the Arab man from the UAE, he said, no, I know you have a translator, but I'm going to speak English for you to understand. This is the only basic idea of speaking somebody's language. It's not about development. Speaking English that have nothing to do with development. So wake up from your dampest. African people, wake up and stop thinking that whenever you speak good English, it means you are going to develop. It has nothing to do with development. If you want to develop, you have to come from your mind. You have to come from what you are about to do. The reason why I can speak English and understand myself is I have a language in me. Listen, the reason why when I speak somebody's language and I'm able to understand myself is I have a language in me which firstly precise or you know prescribe the content in my mind before it come out from my brain or my mouth. So you see, speaking somebody's language does not mean anything. It makes you to understand the person. That's all. Because you have able to have the thought in your brain first. Because you have a language in your brain. Put it aside. Now, let's come to this guy here. This is the main agenda. And this is how it happens around the world. And they are not backing down. The Europeans are not backing down. The Americans are not backing down. The Canadians, the Chinese, the Japanese, Indians, Lebanese. None of them is backing down. Their governments have structures in control that they can always match the Africans boot for boot. Now, you as a young African, I'm talking to you. Come on here. I want to talk to you. Now, one day, most of you will vie for a political positions. Do you understand this content? Do you really know what the consequences about what this the American diplomat is talking about? Do you really understand? Do you know the consequences? Young Africans, when you see it, does it provoke you? To make changes of how you do your things, Do you really care about your poverty, that the whole everyone is describing you as a poor person? No, you still haven't recognized this. So I'm trying to, you know, get you provoked so that you start to look for this, the causes of your problem. Because without finding the cause of your problem, you can't solve it. That is why they told you to go to school, get a certificate, and come. Your government will give you a job. At the end of the day, it tends to be a scam. Do you understand the game that they are playing with you? So you see, this is the deliberate attempt. This is the evilness, the pure evilness by these Europeans or the colonial masters. They plan to destroy you, and they will never leave you alone. So if you are a young African, this is how you start to relieve the fear of seeing the Europeans or seeing the Americans. Like, you fear them because their forefathers have created this mess. They have created this superiority around themselves. That when you see European, you start to pamper them. When you see American, you feel like, you see a white, them. Who is a white man? No. When you start to build your confidence, that's when you can stand up against these people. Now you see your continent. They have used embassies to, you know, you see, they've used embassies to circle the whole continent. And the embassy's job over there is to make sure they will let you continue what their forefathers planted. So listen to this guy. He said, the world have to survive. And for the world to survive, they need to make sure Africa impoverished. They need to make sure Africans become poorer and poorer and poorer so that everybody in this world will see you as a poor person. Period.
Sub-Saharan Africa has been fundamental to the global prosperity of the advanced countries. Okay?
Okay.
And Africa had a role to play. It has a role as a raw material producer. We will not allow Sub-Saharan Africa to escape that. Okay?
Okay, so the question of the day said, we will not allow for the Sub-Saharan African to move on. They will never allow you, and it is true. Now check it. If you think he is joking, check how they always use the embassies to conduct research, conduct symposiums, organizes press conferences, always trying to, you know, influence you with unnecessary things like gayism, lesbian, homosexuality, all things that it does not matter. The Africans know gays for a long time. We don't care. That is not our problem. But yet you see how they use institutions to always make sure get you involved in their discussion. That's why I call it the disorders of Europeans in America tends to be the order of the day. So they think when they have their disorders, they can export that disorder to you. And then you leave your development so that you stay there discussing them. You see how Arab always and exporting their religion to you, the Europeans. They send the religion to you so that you every day you discuss about heaven and hell. You discuss about God and Satan. But you don't discuss about how you build industry, how you build your technology, how you get the technology, how you change the colonial educational system. No, you don't discuss that. See, they know how to get you into their conversation. This is what the guy is talking about. And now, he's saying that maybe you didn't pay attention. He said, they have all the institutions, the academics. Now, I told you the last time that anytime you see African being schooled too much in the Western educational system, that person become a threat to the country. So when you see those, you know, boosting themselves, I'm a PhD this, I'm a colonial, I'm a master's of this, I'm a this, Professor Kominini, I'm a emeritus this. Those are the dangerous people. Most of them are the dangerous people. They are the worst people. They are the informant, which they pursue the agenda of the European master, the agenda of the American colonial master. Watch this. Listen, pay attention.
They do everything to keep Sub-Saharan Africa where it is, also impoverished. It's absolutely...
Okay, so they... According to this man here, he's not playing. This is the reality. If you think they are joking, maybe you are the dumbest person in the whole planet. You see, they will do everything possible to keep Africa where it is. My question is, where are we now? The whole world, Africa is the poorest country or poorest continent on the planet. Is it not true? So do you think they are joking? They are not. So they say they will do everything possible to keep Africa where it is. This is the agenda. And they are not joking at all. And they can do this with the help of your master degree holders, your philosophers, your so-called political analysts, your communicators, your activists. They will do that because they have all those in place.
It's vital for the prosperity of everyone else. So let's get clear about that. Okay, and this means all the economic structures, all the global institutions, and the economics we teach everyone is all designed to keep Africa exactly where it is.
Okay, so this is where it is. It's funny me, and that's the nicest place that I want to talk about here. Listen, all the global economic structure, all the institutions, when it comes to the education, the universities, the training centers, all the everything, global institutions with the IMF and everything. Now, every time you see Africans are struggling, they say, oh, let's go to IMF. And when they go to IMF, they bring back burden to the country. Do you think I'm playing? Do you understand IMF? Internationally Monetary Fund. So the masters of the day will put something there, come and take it. There's no free lunch in anywhere. Don't forget that. And we will take what we want from you. We will give you a closed door meeting. Do this, don't do that. Don't take your young ones into jobs. Don't create jobs. Take this money and go and pay that. Fasika will never go to Yaka. This is what they mean. When they told you that, they said that they have institutions in place. You see the IMF, the World Bank, the United Nations, some part of these organizations within the United Nations. They see you as a low-class human beings. They don't recognize you. Of 54 countries, none of us have been able to obtain a seat as a permanent member of the United Security Council. These are all institutions put in place to make sure you don't get there. And they are not playing. This is a powerful message from this guy. And he's American. And he's a European. Do you think they are joking? Young Africa, wake up. Learn this. Start to learn. Research about it. We are doing research. As long as we move around the world, we do research. We find it. And they are not playing at all. Do you understand how the game is going on? When you go to school, see how you are being taught in school. It's part of this. Because after 4 years coming from the college, you become damp. You become so dependent. You are weak. You can't create. You can't invent. You can't do anything unless you are looking for a job from the government. And the government is also tight with IMF and World Bank and all the global institutions. So where are you going? You will still remain where you are. This is what they mean. And it's ideologically created. It's a world engineered with, you see, the tactical evil planners. These are crooks. They are the same as the slave master back in the 800 years ago. They are the same crooks, and they are not playing at all. So when you see Europeans or Chinese, when they are boosting themselves, they are enjoying, they are still benefiting from the foolishness, the crooks and the mafia, the atrocity that their forefathers created. That's why you see them as best or better or whatever. No, that's not the case. They are benefiting from the foolishness. This is a reason show. So we are here to reason as a young Africans. When you watch this video, make sure you share. I know, you see, they don't want Africans to talk about it. They are interested for you to talk about entertainment, talk about comedy, fight on social media. Why are you talking about this? You're African. You don't need to know this. You don't need to know this. So the video won't go. No. We don't want to push this video for the people to watch. That's a fact. But when you get it, share it, follow it, view it. When you watch it, then you start to recalibrate, re-educating yourself. Because the results tells you that you don't need the professors. You don't need the so-called credential guys to come out and to boost themselves. Why the results is zero? You don't need them. You need critical thinking, analysis. You do the thing. You have your own data to stand back. When you see, do you think these people can stand on me to try to tell me what is wrong and what is bad or who is master or no? But the reason why they have what they have is they did this to me. That is why I'm not able to do anything after school. So apart from that, if they want to come on play field, they should still be on the play field. And let's see who will take the lead. So you see, this is the reason show. I went to a wise is enough. Share the page. And there's more coming. We are doing research. We are researching by our own self. We don't need their data. Does not help me. We have our own data. And the data will expose this thing so that it will help us to develop a structure to fight back, to stand up, to push back. As the Europeans, everybody is pushing back. See the Arabs, they are not playing. Chinese are not playing. It's only you, the African, that you are interested about comedy, jokes, and then talk about sex, who give four rounds, five rounds. This is what you are interested. But that is what they set the institutions for you to be that. You are discussing who will go to heaven, who will go to hell. Meanwhile, you are poor, you are hungry. And if truly Bible has something, will the Chinese print Bible and come and give it to you? See how the greediness of a Chinese. See how greedy Chinese are. They make sure they get everything they want. Do you think if something is in the Bible, they will print it in Beijing, like Hangzhou, and then send it to you in Africa? A word to wise. Let your IQ level go high. Because the last time I checked Chinese, they told their case that Africans have low mentality. They have low IQ, and they are not playing. This is the reason. So share the page. Facebook, YouTube, TikTok, and then Instagram, everywhere. We are the real reasoning, period. Watch it out. I'll see you another time.